A few years ago, we made a Homolia modeling benchmark, which compared different Homolia modeling programs. And it gives me some interesting results. And one example is, for instance, you can look at how good are the models if you measure from different programs. And you can see each program here has a different color. It doesn't really matter which one is each. And the x-axis is the sequence identity, and the y-axis is RMSD, 1 over RMSD. So you see that also you get better model, your higher sequence identity you have. And it's actually very similar. So really it doesn't the methods give some difference, but not the huge differences if you measure there. And you end up with somewhere like on look at the backbone with three almost 30% sequence identity. And if it's 9% you have but 1 angstrom. There are some differences, but not gigantic. If you look at the side chains, you can see this clearly see that there are a couple of methods that are better building side chains than others. That's particularly if you build side chains. The model is actually one of the methods that's bad at building side chains. So here you have colors. The methods were good with squirrel and the squirrel cost. But the methods that we rebuild the side chains after the modeling. So these are good side chains. But in particular, some methods are worse. So there are some differences there. And then there are also some methods that actually make bad chemistry. So basically, they have overlaps or things in bad phi psi angles or something like that. Most methods do that are not really dependent on the sequence identity. They're equally good all the way. We clearly SIGMod and CAD doing the best chemistry. And for instance, model doing a bit worse. But there are a couple of methods that also are dependent. They make better quality of the models to the higher sequence identity you have. But they're never really good in that case, anyhow. There are a few methods that you start out, and if you have some cutoffs or alignments, I mean, you can see that also my methods stand out. But in general, the best methods are very similar in performance. And then the other people know similar things. So you can look at if you have what resolution you have, you should have 80% or 90% of the Ramachandran plot should be in a quality setup. So you can use these type of methods also to evaluate your models. However, they're not really good at saying if a good model is bad, because you see. I mean, you can have a bad model, have fulfill most of these chemical constraints, and you have a good model that doesn't.